What's up, friends of the good mood? This is Manny, and welcome to the two new Next War robots coming into the test server really soon. And let me be the first to introduce them to you guys. We have here, one is called the Behemoth, which, you know, sounds huge and bulky. It's a robot with four heavy weapons. More info coming a little bit later. And then we have the other one is called the Phantom, which has the teleport ability, all right? So, you see it already here on the screenshot. It says behind my webcam, it says teleport on the bottom. So that's, the word that you can't read right now, and those are the ones. Okay, so let's jump into the actual description of things and the upcoming test server. We have right here prepared for you guys the first concept, and this is just concept art of these robots. Okay, just keep that in mind. It's not yet fully finished or so, but they will be looking somewhere around this probably. And this one here is the so-called Phantom robot. But before we come to the robots, let me just go quickly through the active modules and passive module changes for the test server this Saturday. We have the shield breaker module that is still a work in progress, and a lot of feedback has been going in. And basically what it does, it deals now extra damage against energy shields and Aegis shields. It doesn't instantly deplete energy and Aegis shields anymore. It just deals increased damage against them, right? However, the absorber shield from Ares, Hades, and Nemesis will still be one-hit kill. And that's the current model of the of what they are working on with the Shield Breaker active module, and it's probably being tested this way on Saturday. Alright, so let's see how this plays. Of course, we're gonna make a test server video, and we're gonna check it out, and then I'm gonna give you guys my feedback again, same as I did last time. And then we have the Fortifier passive module here that has also changed statistics. We have a physical shield now with plus 25% durability. That's a lot. That's the same amount of durability bonus that you get from the skill, pilot skill also, that you can only get once. Here you can have up to three passive modules with 25% more physical shield durability. Imagine you put this with a pilot skill on a Bulgazari with 4 times 25% more durability on the physical shield. That's gonna be insane. We also have, however, this does not only increase the durability on physical shields, it also increases the energy shield and Aegis shield durability as well, or shield capacity would probably be, let me capacity, do the change on this word. With plus 18% now, it was 15 last time, now it's 18, and also this was changed, and we have an energy shield and Aegis shield regeneration increase of 20%. Okay, so these are the changes for the modules that will be tested on the upcoming test server. And let's come to the first robot. It's called Phantom, okay? It's basically, the description would be somewhere around this: mobile saboteur robot made by Icarus Technology, okay? So it's basically a very advanced technology. And the interesting thing is, when I was at Pixonic headquarters, you know, I brought with me some feedback or some ideas for upcoming robot abilities, maybe, or upcoming robots. And one ability or one robot that you know, pack that I suggested was kind of like a corrosion squad that would have increased corrosion damage on corrosion weapons, maybe, or increased effectiveness on corrosion weapons. Who knows? But they would also have corrosion abilities, pretty much, right? Like an area effect, boom, explosion that would corrode and contaminate the whole area. That was like one side of thing of it. And the names I suggested was Plague and such, like Plague as a name for a robot, for example. Pretty cool. And the other thing that I suggested was a high-tech squad, where one robot has the ability to make a portal. I called it Portal. Place a portal and then warp back into the portal. Same as maybe from the Portal game that you can play on Steam. Somewhere similar to this. And it seems like they have actually picked up this idea, because this here has now a very similar technology than the Portal. It's called Blink. When using the ability, that's the description. When using the ability for the first time, the robot sets up a teleportation beacon, and it receives... by the way, why is it not breaking this here? Should it not be breaking it automatically? Hold on. I hate this. So, here we go. It sets up a teleportation beacon, and receives resistance and increased movement speed. Use the ability for the second time, will teleport the robot to the beacon it placed previously. So you can place a beacon, maybe, very quickly on one spot. You can go over to the site, capture the enemy beacon, and then teleport back into safety. That would be maybe one way of using this. There's probably a lot of different other ways how you could use it too. It will probably, from judging by the stats down here, activating it, and then you have a 15 seconds time window in which you have to make the second teleportation. I don't think you can just place the portal here on Yamantau on one side of the base, walk for 2 minutes to the other side of Yamantau, and then teleport back in one hit. I don't think that will work. You will only have like a 15 seconds time window from placing the portal to activating the teleport back to it. I think that's how it will work. And it has a 10 second cooldown, judging by this, which means you could use it all the time. Like, it's a very, very quick and often useful ability. But of course, it doesn't deal damage, or it doesn't actually do a lot for you. But what it does, it increases your movement speed and it increases your resistance. So the robot would have, as an example, and this is all heavy work in progress, nothing of this must be coming this way. It's a current concept. And HP would be 125,000 on this light robot here, or saboteur robot. And speed 60 kph, so really fast. And it will get 30 kph more speed with the ability running, and 33% more resistance when having the ability running. And keep in mind, you don't have to teleport. You could just use this as a means to get from A to B faster, or to fight a combat with 33% damage resistance running, right? So that's also a way to use it. You don't have to do the teleport, but you can if you want to. And that's an interesting concept, because it opens a whole new category of abilities that are, or ways to use an ability. It's not an offensive or defensive ability. It doesn't have to be that way. It can be like a tricky movement ability, like a jump, or a dash, or a teleport, you know? So, pretty cool. The new robot Phantom, we'll be testing this on a test server coming up really soon, on Saturday. The other robot would be called the Behemoth, okay? It's a heavy robot. The description is not yet finished on it. It's a super heavy robot. It's a bulky robot with 4 heavy weapons, which are available only in stationary mode. So, similar to the Raijin, maybe, where you have to activate your Bastion mode. Is it? I always confuse. It's called Sentry mode on the Fujin, I think, and Bastion mode on the Raijin, right? Am I right? So it's like similar to the Raijin, where you can activate the stationary mode, and when you do this, you have 4 heavy weapons! 4 heavy weapons, ladies and gentlemen. This is the highest firepower ever existed in War Robots, okay? And when it's a really strong and new robot, it may actually also end up getting a lot of passive module slots, so maybe 3. That would mean with 3 damage modules and 4 heavy weapons, imagine on Canyon somebody is sitting on the map with 4 flux weapons and just nailing everyone down who is walking across the open terrain, and just dealing massive damage. It's really insane. 2 weapons, and when it's moving, it will only have 2 heavy weapons, okay? So on the move, you don't have 4 heavy weapons, you only have 2, but in the stationary mode, boom, 4 heavy weapons. Speed also seems to be quite okay with 41 for a heavy, bulky machine. There is no further information. Wait a minute, this is, by the way, the picture. I forgot to go further. Here it is. This would be the picture here. And it's probably important to say that this is not finished. Who knows if there is a built-in resistance. 198,000 HPs I'm not sure what level this is. Probably level 8 stats. So it would have a lot of HP when it's maxed out. Probably somewhere around 300,000 or so. So it will be a really heavy-duty brawling monster, or sniping monster, if you will. I'm not sure about any additional resistance or maybe a physical shield, but let's have a look at the robots directly here. If we have a look at this picture, I'm making this large for you guys so we can get in closer. Those are the 4 heavy weapons. It looks a little bit like Butch, where you have the other 2 weapons in the mobile mode deactivated, looking up, and then they come up and get ready to fire 4 of them at the same time. But unlike Butch, these 2 weapons will stay when he has sentry mode. So all 4 weapons will be activated at the same time. It doesn't look like there is a physical shield, though. Unless there is like some kind of armor plating that will be moving upwards. But it looks like there is no physical shield. The trait of this robot seems to be its absolute damage output. This should be, this will probably be the main trait of this robot. Its massive damage output that it can inflict when it's not moving, when it has just the stationary mode running. It looks so devastating. I wonder how it's like built itself into the ground to be super heavy and having a heavy stand for these four heavy weapons at the same time, man. That's gonna be insane, dude. I would really like to play this thing with like four times Flux and test it, or maybe four times Chimera. Jesus, what you could do with this! Four times Dragoons! Oh my goodness. Of course, I think the Bulwark, however, will still be able to outperform this one on a brawl, because the Bulwark has the Aegis shield and the physical shield, which this robot here may not have. However, it has twice as much damage output, so it's going to be really interesting to see who would win the battle, the Bulwark, or the Behemoth, right? What an awesome name, by the way, Behemoth. This is the Behemoth. Alright, so this is that one here. And from what I can tell, it's not gonna run super fast. It doesn't, but built-in resistance could be a possibility, right? And if we have a look at the Phantom robot, I feel like I see a light or a medium weapons hard point here, right? And to the other side, since this is the backside, so to the left and to the right are weapon hard points. And on top of it, it also looks like there's a hard point for a weapon. So maybe we're gonna have a heavy weapon and a medium here. Or we have these two light weapons. Like I can't judge the size of the weapon by seeing this here so well. But this here looks like it's bigger than this, right? I guess you guys will agree with me that this hard point looks bigger than this one. So maybe this is medium and these are two light weapons? It could be. That would be a decent amount of firepower. It's equivalent to, like, basically 2.5 medium weapons when you have a medium and two lights. Or you have a heavy and two lights, and that would be insanely much firepower, similar to Raker, Pursuer, or, you know, all these kinds of robots. So it's gonna be interesting to see what kind of weapons we have. It's definitely gonna be a hard or fast running robot, and this here in the back of the robot seems to be some kind of singularity or engine for the portal to be placed and to increase its speed, right? So, yeah, really interesting to see this coming up, guys. This will be a video coming up. We've been testing this on the test server on Saturday, so get ready for it, guys, and I'm gonna just show you guys the picture again that I've made. I worked on this for quite a bit, and I colored the trebuchets in red, so they really, you know, stick out of the picture with some crazy heavy firepower. So get ready for the test server video coming this Saturday, guys, and tell me also, yeah, share your comments, your comments, your thoughts on these robots. Tell me what useful ability or how you would use the teleport ability, maybe. What ideas do you have? And also, of course, guys, here, boom, hit subscribe on the channel if you haven't done that yet, guys. And if you want to stay tuned for more upcoming videos. And by the way, we're having a giveaway coming up within the next days too, right? So keep that in mind. A giveaway with 50 robots will be coming up super soon, okay? Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like and comment down below. And if you haven't already, hit subscribe as brutal as a man can hit for more. Thanks for bearing with me. You guys are awesome as always. Money Gaming signing off. Bye-bye.